The European Space Agency says China experienced a 20 to 30% drop of the air pollutant nitrogen dioxide from between mid-December to mid-March.
It was certainly due to the fact that in the Hubei region in China, all activities were reduced dramatically due to the lockdown.
Beatriz Cardenas of the World Resources Institute in Mexico explains how nitrogen dioxide affects the air.
What it does once it's in the atmosphere is not only it has some impacts on the environment and health of the people, but it's also it's a key pollutant in terms of atmospheric chemistry. Because once it's in the atmosphere, it can react with other pollutants to produce other pollutants.
All that pollution makes it harder to stay healthy.
Being exposed to air pollutants make you more vulnerable to infections like this virus or bacteria.
Analysis by Greenpeace also shows the pollutant emissions in Beijing and its surrounding areas dropped. Compared to previous years, streets and landmarks are no longer covered in smog. Lin Liu is a senior climate and energy campaigner with Greenpeace.
In fact, there are a lot of reasons behind the improvement of overall air quality. But there are two main factors. One is that factories were shut down during the epidemic. The other is the change of people's lifestyle, especially the reduction of traffic.
Beijing resident Liu Chuan takes this as a potential health benefit.
It feels like the air is overall much less polluted than it used to be. It also improves people's mood.
In Europe, cities including Madrid, Brussels, Paris, Milan, and Frankfurt also showed a reduction in average levels of nitrogen dioxide, according to the Sentinel-5 satellite images. In America, Los Angeles, a city with one of the worst smog problems in the country, is experiencing a third straight week of clean air. All this is leading some to wonder if stay-at-home orders are helping to reduce pollution levels. California scientists are looking at the data, but say they haven't reached a conclusion.
Human activities that cause emissions have been diminished. It has rained every other day or every third day. And under those conditions, those are the days where we typically see very good air quality days.
Cardenas says whether it's related to a decrease in human activity or weather patterns, there are some lessons to be learned when this is all over. Mariama Diallo, VOA News.